everyone, this is Meera Gupta. Welcome back to online English classes. Today I'm going to continue the left part from class 10th English, chapter 8, Miss Will the Otter, written by Gavin Maxwell. I hope you understood the earlier video, and let us start the next part from para 13. But before starting, let us recall the story. Here, in earlier paragraph, we have seen that after having the meal, narrator faced what he feared the most. The box where the Miss Will was kept was steel, and the blood was dripping out of its air holes. He panicked and opened the box only to find the inner lining torn by frightened mice. The narrator removed every piece of the sharp metal lining and cleaned the box. Till the time everything was back in place, it was only 10 minutes left for the flight to take off, and they had to cover a distance of 5 miles. Gavin placed mice in the box and closed the lid with his hand, lest he should escape. Okay, now let's start the next para, para 13. I sat in the back of the car with the box beside me as the driver tore through the street of Basra like a ricocheting bullet. The aircraft was waiting to take off. I was rushed through to it by infuriated officials. Luckily, the seat booked for me was at the string front. I covered the floor around my feet with newspaper, rang for the air hostess, and gave her a parcel of fish for Miss to keep in a cool place. I took her into my confidence about the events of the last half hour. I have retained the most profound admiration for the air hostess. She was the very queen of her kind. She suggested that I might prefer to have my pet on my knee, and I could have kissed her hand in the depth of my gratitude. But not knowing others, I was quite unprepared for what followed. Ricocheting bullet. Ricocheting bullet here means a bullet which changes direction after hitting a surface. Okay, now another difficult word is infuriated. Infuriated here means very angry. Very angry took her into my confidence here means shared with her my experience or secrets. Okay, now listen the explanation. In this paragraph, the narrator said that he cleaned the mess and hurried in the cab. The cab went extremely fast, negotiating the turns like ricocheting bullet. He somehow managed to reach just before the flight took off, thereby annoying the officials. He got in his seat and gave Miss Will food package of fish to the air hostess for refrigeration. He told her the incident which had delayed them, and she gladly understood while explaining him what to do next. Gavin developed extreme admiration for the air hostess as she was very helpful. He took her advice and kept the box on his lap. He felt like kissing her hand as a token of thanks for help. Okay, now see the next paragraph, para 14. There were squawks and shrieks, and a woman stood up on her seat screaming out, "A rat, a rat." I caught sight of Miss Tail disappearing beneath the legs of a portly white turbaned Indian. Diving for it, I missed but found my face covered in curry. "Perhaps," said the air hostess with the most charming smile, It would be better if you resumed your seat and I will find the animal and bring it to you. Now here, portly. Portly here means stout. Okay? Now listen the explanation. What happened then? As soon as the author opened the box, Miss jumped out of it and became disappeared. There was quiet all around. Passengers were getting scared. A lady climbed upon her chair. When he saw Miss beneath the seat of a white turbaned man, he attempted to catch Miss and ended up getting his face covered in a curry, only to find that Miss had vanished again. Just then, the air hostess extended the offer to help find Miss and advise him to go back to his seat. Now here, the air hostess was ready to help him in finding Miss. Now see the next paragraph. Para 50. I returned to my seat. I was craning my neck, trying to follow the hunt, when suddenly I heard from my feet a distressed chitter of recognition and welcome, and Miss bounded onto my knee and began to nuzzle my face and my neck. Craning here means stretch out one's body or neck in order to see something. Distressed here means troubled. And recognition here means identification, acknowledgement. Either identification or acknowledgement. And nuzzle here means to rub gently with the nose. Bounded onto means climbed up quickly. Now listen the explanation. On being requested by the air hostess, the narrator came back to his seat. And his eyes started looking for Miss. It was only then he heard some chitter while Miss climbed up his knee to reach his face. Miss has returned. Okay. Now see the next paragraph, para 60. After an eventful journey, Maxwell and his otter reach London, where he has a flat. Miss and I remained in London for nearly a month. He would play for hours with a selection of toys, ping pong balls, marbles, rubber fruit, and a terrapin shell that I had brought back from his native Marseille. With the ping pong ball, he invented a game of his own which could keep him engrossed for up to half an hour at a time. A suitcase that I had taken to Iraq had become damaged on the journey home, so that the lid, when closed, remained at the slope from one end to the other. Miss discovered that if he placed the ball on the high end, it would run down the length of the suitcase. He would dash around to the other end to ambush its arrival, hide from it, crouching to spring up and take it by surprise, grab it and trot off with it to the high end once more. Now listen the difficult meaning here. Terrapin. Terrapin shell here means the shell of a small turtle found in North America. Engrossed here means completely interested. Ambush here means to attack suddenly from a hidden position. Crouching here means squat or adopt a position where the knees are bent and the upper body is brought forward and down, typically in order to avoid detection or to defend oneself. And trot off here means to leave. Now listen the explanation. What happened? The narrator and Miss, they both stayed in London for a month while Miss had learned to engross himself with tons of games. He used to play with ping pong balls, marbles, rubber fruit, and the terrapin shell. Ping pong ball kept him engaged for about half an hour. Gavin's suitcase had got damaged on the journey. It had a slope from one end to other. Miss would roll the ball from the higher end towards the lower end. Then he would rush to the lower end and hide, waiting for the ball to reach. He would jump up in the time and surprise the ball. Then he would catch the ball and rush once again to the higher end of the suitcase. Very excitingly, he would again hit the ball from the other end. Okay, now see para 17. Outside the house, I exercised him on a lead precisely as if he had been a dog. Miss quickly developed certain compulsive habits on these walks in the London streets, like the ritual of children who on their way to and from school must place their feet squarely on the center of each paving block, must touch every seventh upright of the iron railings, or pass to the outside of every second lamp post. Opposite to my flat was a single-storied primary school along whose frontage ran a low wall some 2 feet high. On his way home, but never on his way out, Miss would tug me to this wall, jump onto it, and go lap the full length of its 30 yards to the hopeless distraction both of people's and of his staff with it. Compulsive hair means irresistible. Ritual hair means a religious ceremony. Tug means pull, and gallop hair means run fast. Now listen to the explanation. I hope you are understanding the chapter. Okay. So Gavin would take Miss for a walk and exercise just like a pet dog. Miss Will ran around the street in a particular fashion, just like school kids did. Like children form different habits of placing their feet in the center of each block that came their way, or of touching every seventh pole of the railing, or criss-crossing out of the street light poles. There was a primary school with only the ground floor being constructed opposite the other's flat. There was a low height wall, almost 2 feet high, and ran along the school's boundary. On their way back home, only Miss would pull Gavin towards the wall, jump onto it, and ran on its entire length at a high speed. He would attract the attention of the students and staff inside the school. Okay? Now see the next para, para 80. It is not, I suppose, in any way strange that the average Londoner should not recognize an otter. But the variety of guesses as to what kind of animal this might be came as a surprise to me. Otters belong to a comparatively small group of animals called mustelids, shared by the buzzard, mongoose, weasel, stoat, mink, and others. I faced a continuous barrage of conjectural questions that spread all the mustelids. But the otter more random guesses hit on a baby seal and a squirrel. Is that walrus, mister? Reduced me to the giggles. And outside a dog, so I heard a hippo, a beaver, a bear cub, a leopard, on, and one apparently that had changed its spots, and a bronzer. Miss was anything but an otter. Okay, Now barrages of conjectural question here means a stream of question filled with guesses. Okay. Now listen to the explanation. As an otter is not a very common animal in London, the author found it strange that the residents were unable to recognize one. People had wild guesses as to what Miss was. Otters belong to a group of animals called the mastelins, seared by a badger, mongoose, weasel, stoat, mink and others. People could guess all animals of the group but otter. Most famous guesses were a baby seal or a squirrel. Some guessed that Miss Will was a hippo, beaver, leopard, walrus, etc. Okay? Now see the next paragraph, and this is the last paragraph of this story. Para 19. But the question for which I awarded the highest score came from a laborer digging a hole in the street. I was still far from him when he laid down his tool, but his hands on his hips and began to stare. As I drew nearer, I saw his expression of surprise and affront, as though he would have me know that he was not one upon whom to play jokes. I came abreast of him. He spat, glared, and then growled out, "Here, mister, what is that supposed to be?" This is means the story is ended by asking a question, "What is that supposed to be?" Affront here means insult, and spat, it is a past tense of spit. Okay? Now listen to the explanation. Here in the last paragraph, the narrator says that the most shocking reply came from a laborer digging a hole who paused working while observing Miss. Means when he observed Miss, he was totally surprised. The man kept his tool aside, placed his hand on his back, and stared at Miss. He stopped doing his work. His full attention was in front of Miss. His expression of surprise and affront signaled that he would not tolerate any nonsense. He spat, stared at them, and asked the author in a loud voice that what was that? What was that? What indicate here to Miss Bill? What was Miss Bill supposed to be? Okay, so here the story is ended. I hope you understood this chapter. Let's see the moral of the story. After reading this chapter, what you have learned from the story, or what moral lesson you have got from the story? The lesson tells us about a great concern of a human being to the animals. The otter was a kind of unknown animal to the author. Means before meeting with otter, the author didn't know about that kind of animal. When it came first to him, it looked like a small dragon. In the beginning, Miss Will showed no interest in Maxwell, but later on he lost his apathy and started showing interest in him. So in this way, they both attached with each other and concerned for each other. Here the narrator shows his concern to the animal beings. Okay, so I hope you understood this chapter. Go through once, twice or thrice a time and read this chapter thoroughly and try to understand it. And some important question from this chapter we will discuss in the next video. Till then, take care, goodbye, have a nice day.